Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's contrast what we'll encounter in this playlist, acidic reactions of carbonyls, with what we've seen in other playlists, basic reactions of carbonyls. One of the main reactions of carbonyls is with nucleophiles. Under basic conditions, you often have strong nucleophiles. This is the top reaction. The carbonyl is a weak electrophile. And the strong nucleophile attacks it to give a tetrahedral intermediate, which goes off and does more chemistry. Under acidic conditions, you won't have strong nucleophiles, just weak ones. That's actually okay. Under acidic conditions, you'll get protonation of the carbonyl. This protonated carbonyl is very electron poor. It's now a strong electrophile. That means even weak nucleophiles like alcohols or water can attack it. The result of this attack is a new intermediate. While you could call this a tetrahedral intermediate, most people don't. The term tetrahedral intermediate is normally reserved for anionic intermediates, like what we saw up in the top reaction. Regardless, this intermediate in the lower right can continue to react. Okay, that's how nucleophiles work. Let's see another acid-base contrast. On top, we have a strong base deprotonating a weakly acidic alpha hydrogen of a ketone to make an enolate. Enolates are great nucleophiles. Even though the resonance stabilized, they're still very electron rich, and they react with a range of weak electrophiles. On the bottom, instead, we are under acidic conditions. We can protonate the carbonyl, just as we saw on the previous slide. What happens next is that the protonated carbonyl is deprotonated by a weak base, perhaps water, on the alpha carbon. This process is called a tautomerization. It gives the enol form of our original ketone. So this is the keto form. Again, this process is a tautomerization. The enol is a weak nucleophile at the alpha carbon. So it's actually similar to, but less reactive than, the enolate we saw on the top half of the screen. So we've seen that even under acidic conditions, you can get nucleophilic attack on carbonyls and something that behaves like a weak enolate. We'll spend the rest of the playlist expanding on these two ideas.